हेलो एवरीवन, आज हम यूनिट 15 पॉलीमर्स क्लास 12 केमिस्ट्री की बुक से रीडिंग करेंगे। ये एक ऑडियो बुक है रिवीजन पर्पस के लिए, इसमें किसी भी टाइप का एक्सप्लेनेशन नहीं है। कोपॉलीमराइजेशन हैज बीन यूज्ड बाय नेचर इन पॉलीपेप्टाइड्स व्हिच मे कंटेन एज मेनी एज 20 डिफरेंट अमीनो एसिड्स। केमिस्ट आर स्टिल फार बिहाइंड। Do you think that daily life would have been easier and colorful without the discovery and varied applications of polymers? The use of polymers in the manufacture of plastic buckets, cups and saucers, children toys, packaging bags, synthetic clothing materials, automobile tires, gears and seals, electrical insulating materials and machine parts has completely revolutionized the daily life as well as the industrial scenario. Indeed, the polymers are the backbone of four major industries, namely plastics, elastomers, fibers, and paints and varnishes. The word polymer is coined from two Greek words. Poly means many and mer means unit or part. The term polymer is defined as very large molecules having high molecular mass, in bracket 10^3 to 10^7 atomic mass unit. These are also referred to as macromolecules, which are formed by joining of repeating structural units on a large scale. The repeating structural units are derived from some simple and reactive molecules known as monomers and are linked to each other by covalent bonds. The process of formation of polymers from respective monomers is called polymerization. 15.1 Classification of polymers. There are several ways of classification of polymers based on some special considerations. One of the common classifications of polymer is based on source from which polymer is derived. Under this type of classification, there are three subcategories. First, natural polymers. These polymers are found in plants and animals. Examples are proteins, cellulose, starch, some resins, and rubber. Second, semi-synthetic polymers. Cellulose derivatives as cellulose acetate in bracket rayon and cellulose nitrate, etc., are the usual examples of this subcategory. Third, synthetic polymers. A variety of synthetic polymers as plastic in bracket polythene, synthetic fibers in bracket nylon 66, and synthetic rubbers in bracket Buna S are examples of man-made polymers extensively used in daily life as well as in industry. Polymers can be classified on the basis of their structure, molecular forces, or modes of polymerization. 15.2 Types of polymerization reactions. There are two broad types of polymerization reaction, that is, the addition or chain growth polymerization and condensation or step growth polymerization. In this type, 15.2.1 addition polymerization or chain growth polymerization. In this type of polymerization, the molecules of the same monomer or different monomers add together on a large scale to form a polymer. The monomers are used are unsaturated compounds. For example, alkenes, alkadienes, and the derivatives. This mode of polymerization leads to an increase in chain length, and chain growth can take place through the formation of either free radicals or ionic spaces. However, the free radical governed addition or chain growth polymerization is the most common mode. 15.2.1.1 Mechanism of addition polymerization. First, free radical mechanism. A variety of alkenes or dienes and the derivatives are polymerized in the presence of a free radical generating initiator in bracket catalyst like benzoyl peroxide, acetyl peroxide, tert butyl peroxide, etc. For example, the polymerization of ethene to polythene consists of heating or exposing to light a mixture of ethene with a small amount of benzoyl peroxide initiator. The process starts with the addition of phenyl free radical formed by the peroxide to the ethene double bond, thus generating a new and larger free radical. This step is called chain initiating step. As this radical reacts with another molecule of ethene, another bigger sized radical is formed. The repetition of this sequence with new and bigger radicals carries the reaction forward, and the step is termed as chain propagating step. Ultimately, at some stage, the product radical thus formed reacts with another radical to form the polymerized product. This step is called the chain terminating step. The sequence of steps involved in the formation of polyethylene are depicted as follows. Chain initiation steps. Chain propagating step. Chain terminating step. For termination of the long chain, these free radicals can combine in different ways to form polyethylene. One mode of termination of chain is shown as under. The addition polymers formed by the polymerization of a single monomeric species are known as homopolymers. For example, polyethylene discussed above is a homopolymer. The polymers made by addition polymerization from two different monomers are termed as copolymers. Buna S, which is formed by polymerization of buta-1,3-diene and styrene, is an example of copolymer formed by addition polymerization. 1,3-butadiene plus styrene will form butadiene-styrene copolymer, common name Buna S. 15.2.1.2 Some important addition polymers. A. Polyethene. Polyethenes are linear or slightly branched long chain molecules. These are capable of repeatedly softening on heating and hardening on cooling, and are thus thermoplastic polymers. There are two types of polyethene as given below. First, low density polyethene. It is obtained by the polymerization of ethene under high pressure of 1000 to 2000 atmospheres at a temperature of 350 Kelvin to 570 Kelvin in the presence of traces of dioxygen or a peroxide initiator, in bracket catalyst. The low density polyethene, in bracket LDP, is obtained through the free radical addition and hydrogen atom abstraction. It has highly branched structure. These polymers have straight chain structure with some branches as shown below. Low density polyethylene is chemically inert and tough but flexible and a poor conductor of electricity. Hence, it is used in the insulation of electricity carrying wires and manufacture of squeeze bottles, toys and flexible pipes. Second, high density polyethylene. It is formed when addition polymerization of ethene takes place in a hydrocarbon solvent in the presence of a catalyst such as triethyl aluminium and titanium tetrachloride, in bracket Ziegler-Natta catalyst, at a temperature of 333 Kelvin to 343 Kelvin and under a pressure of 6 to 7 atmospheres. High density polyethylene, in bracket HDP, thus produced consists of linear molecules as shown below and has a high density due to close packing. Such polymers are also called linear polymers. High density polymers are also chemically inert and more tough and hard. It is used for manufacturing buckets, dustbins, bottles, pipes, etc. B. Polytetrafluoroethene, in bracket Teflon. Teflon is manufactured by heating tetrafluoroethene with a free radical or persulfate catalyst at high pressures. It is chemically inert and resistant to attack by corrosive reagents. It is used in making oil seals and gaskets and also used for non-stick surface coated utensils. Tetrafluoroethene, in presence of catalyst and high pressure, gives Teflon. C. Polyacrylonitrile. The addition polymerization of acrylonitrite in presence of a peroxide catalyst leads to the formation of polyacrylonitrile. NCH2 double bond CHCN, that is acrylonitrile, in presence of peroxide catalyst, polymerization reaction will take place and gives you polyacrylonitrile. Polyacrylonitrile is used as a substitute for wool in making commercial fibers as Orlon or acrylene. Example 15.1 is CH2CHC6H5 in bracket over N a homopolymer or a copolymer? Solution: it is a homopolymer and the monomer from which it is obtained is styrene, that is C6H5CH double bond CH2. 15.2.2 Condensation polymerization or step growth polymerization. This type of polymerization generally involves a repetitive condensation reaction between two bifunctional or trifunctional monomeric units. This polycondensation reactions may result in the loss of some simple molecules as water, alcohol, hydrogen chloride, etc., and lead to the formation of high molecular mass condensation polymers. In these reactions, the product of each step is again a bifunctional species and the sequence of condensation goes on. Since each step produces a distinct functionalized species and is independent of each other, this process is also called as step growth polymerization. The formation of terylene or dacrone by the interaction of ethylene glycol and terephthalic acid is an example of this type of polymerization. Ethylene glycol in bracket ethane 1,2-diol plus terephthalic acid in bracket benzene 1,4-dicarboxylic acid gives terylene or dacrone. 15.2.2.1 Some important condensation polymers. A. Polyamides. These polymers possessing amide linkage are important examples of synthetic fibers and are termed as nylons. The general method of preparation consists of the condensation polymerization of diamines with dicarboxylic acids or condensation of amino acids or their lectins. Nylon 6,6. It is prepared by the condensation polymerization of hexamethylene diamine with adipic acid under high pressure and at high temperature. This one is adipic acid. This is hexamethylene diamine in presence of 553 Kelvin temperature and high pressure will give you nylon 6,6. This structure is for nylon 6,6 and plus NH2O will remove. Nylon 6,6 is fiber forming solid. It possesses high tensile strength. This characteristic can be attributed to the strong intermolecular forces like hydrogen bonding. These strong forces also lead to close packing of chains and thus impart crystalline nature. Nylon 6,6 is used in making sheets, bristles for brushes and in textile industry. Second, nylon 6. It is obtained by heating caprolactam with water at high temperature. Caprolactam in presence of 533 to 543 Kelvin temperature, water will give you nylon 6. Nylon 6 is used for the manufacture of tire cords, fabrics and ropes. B. Polyesters. These are the polycondensation products of dicarboxylic acids and diols. Dacrone or terylene is the best known example of polyesters. It is manufactured by heating a mixture of ethylene glycol and terephthalic acid at 420 to 460 Kelvin in the presence of zinc acetate antimony trioxide catalyst as per the reaction given earlier. Dacrone fiber in bracket terylene is crease resistance and is used in blending with cotton and wool fibers and also as glass reinforcing materials in safety helmets, etc. C. Phenol formaldehyde polymer in bracket bakelite and related polymers. Phenol formaldehyde polymers are the oldest synthetic polymers. These are obtained by the condensation reaction of phenol with formaldehyde in the presence of either an acid or a base catalyst. The reaction starts with the initial formation of ortho and or para-hydroxymethyl phenol derivatives, which further react with phenol to form compounds having rings joined to each other through CH2 groups. The initial product could be a linear product, Novolac used in paints. Novolac on heating with formaldehyde undergoes cross-linking to form an infusible solid mass called bakelite. It is thermosetting polymer which cannot be reused or remolded. Thus, bakelite is formed by cross-linking of linear chains of the polymer Novolac. Bakelite is used for making combs, phonograph records, electrical switches, and handles of various utensils. D. Melamine formaldehyde polymer. Melamine formaldehyde polymer is formed by the condensation polymerization of melamine and formaldehyde. This one is melamine plus formaldehyde, that is HCHO, gives you resin intermediate. Then with polymerization reaction, melamine polymer will form. It is used in manufacture of unbreakable crockery. 15.2.3 Copolymerization. Copolymerization is a polymerization reaction in which a mixture of more than one monomeric species is allowed to polymerize and form a copolymer. The copolymer can be made not only by chain growth polymerization but by step growth polymerization also. It contains multiple units of each monomer used in the same polymeric chain. For example, a mixture of buta-1,3-diene and styrene can form a copolymer. NCH2 double bond CH, CH double bond CH2 is 1,3-butadiene plus styrene on benzene ring CH double bond CH2 will form butadiene-styrene copolymer. Copolymers have properties quite different from homopolymers. For example, butadiene-styrene copolymer is quite tough and is a good substitute for natural rubber. It is used for the manufacture of auto tires, floor tiles, footwear components, cable insulation, etc. Rubber. First, natural rubber. Rubber is a natural polymer and possesses elastic properties. It is also termed as elastomeric polymer. In elastomeric polymers, the polymer chains are held together by the weak intermolecular forces. This weak binding forces permit the polymer to be stretched. A few cross links are introduced in between the chains, which help the polymer to retract to its original position after the force is released. Rubber has a variety of uses. It is manufactured from rubber latex, which is a colloidal dispersion of rubber in water. This latex is obtained from the rubber tree, which is found in India, Sri Lanka, Indonesia, Malaysia, and South America. Natural rubber may be considered as a linear polymer of isoprene in bracket 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene and is also called as cis-1,4-polyisoprene. This is the structure of natural rubber and this is the structure of isoprene. The cis-polyisoprene molecule consists of various chains held together by weak van der Waals interactions and has a coiled structure. Thus, it can be stretched like a spring and exhibits elastic properties. Vulcanization of rubber. Natural rubber becomes soft at high temperature, in bracket greater than 335 Kelvin, and brittle at low temperatures, in bracket less than 283 Kelvin, and shows high water absorption capacity. It is soluble in non-polar solvents and is known resistance to attack by oxidizing agents. To improve upon these physical properties, a process of vulcanization is carried out. This process consists of heating a mixture of raw rubber with sulfur and an appropriate additive at a temperature range between 373 Kelvin to 415 Kelvin. On vulcanization, sulfur forms cross links at the reactive sites of double bonds and thus the rubber gets stiffened. In the manufacture of tire rubber, 5% of sulfur is used as a cross-linking agent. The probable structures of vulcanized rubber molecules are depicted below. Second, synthetic rubbers. Synthetic rubber is any vulcanizable rubber like polymer which is capable of getting stretched to twice its length. However, it returns to its original shape and size as soon as external stretching force is released. Thus, synthetic rubbers are either homopolymers of 1,3-butadiene derivatives or copolymers of 1,3-butadiene or its derivatives with another unsaturated monomer. Preparation of synthetic rubbers. First, neoprene. Neoprene or polychloroprene is formed by the free radical polymerization of chloroprene. Chloroprene, that is 2-chloro-1,3-buta-1,3-diene, with the help of polymerization reaction, gives you neoprene. It has superior resistance to vegetable and mineral oils. It is used for manufacturing conveyor belts, gaskets, and hoses. Second, Buna-N. You have already studied about Buna-S in section 15.1.3. Buna-N is obtained by the copolymerization of 1,3-buta-1,3-diene and acrylonitrile in the presence of a peroxide catalyst. This is 1,3-butadiene, CH2 double bond CH, CH double bond CH2, and N number of molecule we have to take, plus acrylonitrile, this is NCH2 double bond CH, and CN. Copolymerization reaction will give you Buna-N. It is resistant to the action of petrol, lubricating oil, and organic solvents. It is used in making oil seals, tank lining, etc. 15.3 Molecular mass of polymers. Polymer properties are closely related to their molecular mass, size, and structure. The growth of the polymer chain during their synthesis is dependent upon the availability of the monomers in the reaction mixture. Thus, the polymer sample contains chains of varying lengths and hence its molecular mass is always expressed as an average. The molecular mass of polymers can be determined by chemical and physical methods. 15.4 Biodegradable polymers. A large number of polymers are quite resistant to the environmental degradation processes and are thus responsible for the accumulation of polymeric solid waste materials. This solid waste causes acute environmental problems and remain undegraded for quite a long time. In view of the general awareness and concern for the problems created by the polymeric solid waste, certain new biodegradable synthetic polymers have been designed and developed. These polymers contain functional groups similar to the functional groups present in biopolymers. Aliphatic polyesters are one of the important classes of biodegradable polymers. Some important examples are given below. First, poly-beta-hydroxy-butyrate co-beta-hydroxy-valerate in bracket PHBV. PHBV is very important for your exams. It is obtained by the copolymerization of 3-hydroxybutanoic acid and 3-hydroxypentanoic acid. PHBV is used in specialty packaging, orthopedic devices, and in controlled release of drugs. PHBV undergoes bacterial degradation in the environment. 3-hydroxybutanoic acid plus 3-hydroxypentanoic acid will give you PHBV. Second, nylon 2, nylon 6. Second, nylon 2, nylon 6. It is an alternating polyamide copolymer of glycine in bracket H2N bond CH2 bond COOH and amino caproic acid in bracket H2N in small bracket CH2 bracket over 5 COOH and is biodegradable. Can you write the structure of this copolymer? 15.5 Polymers of commercial importance. Besides the polymers already discussed, some other commercially important polymers along with their structures and uses are given below in Table 15.1. Table 15.1, some other commercially important polymers. Name of polymer, polypropene, monomer, propene. Structure is given here. Uses, manufacture of ropes, toys, pipes, fibers, etc. Then second one is polystyrene, monomer is styrene. Structure is given. Uses as insulator, wrapping material, manufacture of toys, radio and television cabinets. Then third one is polyvinyl chloride in bracket PVC and its monomer is vinyl chloride. Structure is given. Uses manufacture of raincoats, handbags, vinyl flooring and water pipes. Then ultra formaldehyde resin, its monomer is, first one is urea and second one is formaldehyde. Then its uses are for making unbreakable cups and laminated sheets. Then we have glyptal. Monomers are ethylene glycol and phthalic acid. Uses manufacture of paints and lacquers. Then last one is bakelite. Monomers are phenol and formaldehyde. Uses for making combs, electrical switches, handles of utensils and computer disks. Summary. Polymers are defined as high molecular mass macromolecules, which consist of repeating structural units derived from the corresponding monomers. These polymers may be of natural or synthetic origin and are classified in a number of ways. In the presence of an organic peroxide initiator, the alkenes and the derivatives undergo addition polymerization or chain growth polymerization through a free radical mechanism. Polyethylene, Teflon, Orlone, etc. are formed by addition polymerization of an appropriate alkene or its derivative. Condensation polymerization reactions are shown by the interaction of bi- or polyfunctional monomers containing NH2, OH and COOH groups. This type of polymerization proceeds through the elimination of certain simple molecules as H2O, CH3OH, etc. Formaldehyde reacts with phenol and melamine to form the corresponding condensation polymer products. The condensation polymerization progresses through step by step and is also called as step growth polymerization. Nylon, bakelite and dacrone are some of the important examples of condensation polymers. However, a mixture of two unsaturated monomers exhibits copolymerization and forms a copolymer containing multiple units of each monomer. Natural rubber is a cis-1,4 polyisoprene and can be made more tough by the process of vulcanization with sulfur. Synthetic rubbers are usually obtained by copolymerization of alkene and 1,3-butadiene derivatives. In view of the potential environmental hazards of synthetic polymeric waste, certain biodegradable polymers such as PHBV and nylon 2, nylon 6 are developed as alternatives.